Hi. Today I want to show you how to sequence your desktop synth or your rack using Ableton with Max for Life. To do this, I'll be using this Max for Life MIDI device that's inspired by the Roland M185 sequencer, and it turns the standard 8-step sequencer on its head by breaking each step into a stage. Each stage can be anywhere from 1 to 8 steps long, sending gates at different times throughout the stage, effectively turning 8 steps into as many as 64. So what does all that mean exactly? Let me show you, and I hope it'll make a little bit more sense. I'm using this sequencer to drive a Moog Siren that I was sitting here on my desktop. You can see the software interface for that on the screen here. And on the sequencer itself, I've got 3 steps going. Before I turn the audio on, let me just start a simple drum pattern to get a sense of time. Then I'll turn on the track of the sequencer. Playing 3 stages here. Let me start playing around with the pitches and try and create a sequence that I find interesting. And right off the bat, I actually don't want to be playing in that high of a frequency range, so I'm going to go down here. I'm going to command click on this bar, and I can actually move this whole range down, give myself a little bit more flexibility. A simple 3-note phrase. Let's change the count on one of the stages. I'll change the first one to 3. So you can hear it's now playing on the first beat of that first stage, and then pausing for the second 2 beats. And I can have it play on the second beat by changing the mode. All the beats. So really quickly, you can see just with 3 stages on, how you can start to move things around and make some really interesting phrases really quickly by changing the how many counts are in each stage and when within the count it's changing by changing the mode. So mode section's kind of deep. You can either turn that stage off, have it play on the first beat, all the beats, the seconds, every second beat, every third. If this count were longer, you could hear it do every fourth. This question mark is actually played randomly. And this last one will just hold for the duration of the beat. So let's play around a bit with the counts and the modes to see if we can develop a longer sequence. So now I'm using 5 stages. I've got 8, but I'm only using 5. And here I've got a pretty interesting sequence going just by playing around with the counts and the pitches, changing a few of the modes. One thing I like to do also is I use this MIDI pitch quantizer on the side, and I can just keep on the notes that are playing and turn off the notes that aren't. Slide these pitches around. going to stay within those notes. Let's change the clock tempo and see what happens. Duration knob, you can change the note length as well. And there you have it. M185 sequencer was an incredibly playable sequencer, and what I love about this Max for Live device is that it allows you to spend more time adjusting the settings to get interesting ideas out rather than just twiddling with settings to try and get it to work the way you want. Sparks lots of creative ideas, and every time I drop it into my Ableton project, I find something interesting with it. You can use it to trigger a VST inside of Ableton, or to drive an external desktop synth or a Eurorack synth. You can download that device for free in the link below, linked in the description. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.